In our night sky, located in the constellation Ophiuchus, there is an unremarkable red dwarf star some 6 light-years away. After the 3 stars of the Alpha Centauri system, this is the closest star to us. Known as Barnard's star, it is invisible to the unaided eye. You need a telescope to see it from Earth. Its name comes from its discoverer, E.E. Barnard, who, in 1916, noticed that this star was wobbling back and forth by some 10.3 arcseconds every year. Astronomers thought there must be some unseen companion orbiting around it, but for over a century, no one could find it. Was it a dim star, or was it a planet? Why was this star wobbling? Now we know. Astronomers using the planet-hunting instrument known as HARPS and others from around the world have pinpointed this unseen companion. By measuring the spectrum of the star for long periods of time, astronomers measured the shift in the spectral lines as the star wobbled. When something orbits a star, its gravitational pull causes it to move to and fro. When the star moves away from the Earth, its spectrum redshifts. In other words, it moves towards longer wavelengths. Similarly, starlight is shifted towards bluer, shorter wavelengths when the star moves towards Earth. These shifts can tell us a lot about the unseen companion around Barnard's star. This is called the radial velocity method. So, what's in orbit around Barnard's star? The observations from HARPS and 7 other instruments spanning 20 years indicate that there is a rocky, super-Earth-sized planet circling the 4th closest star to us. Called unimaginatively Barnard Star B, it has a mass at least 3.2 times that of the Earth, and it orbits its host star once every 233 days. Because Barnard's star is very small and dim, the light from it provides this planet with only 2% of the energy that the Earth gets from the Sun. Even though Barnard's star B is about twice as close to its star as the Earth is from the Sun, the low energy the planet gets from the star means it is very cold, close to what astronomers call the snow line. If there is any water there, it would be solid ice. The temperature on this world is minus 170 degrees Celsius, making this planet inhospitable to life as we know it here. The stars in our stellar neighborhood turn out to have many planets. Alongside Proxima Centauri b, the 7 worlds of TRAPPIST-1, Epsilon Eridani b, and Ross 128, we can now add another, Barnard's star b, a cold super-Earth on the edge of habitability.